Nokia N900 expected fourth quarter 2009. The Nokia N900 is the latest in Nokia's series of internet tablets, but perhaps more significantly, the N900 is Nokia's first Linux-based mobile phone. This is a significantly different device from previous Nokia internet tablets, and in fact there are very few handsets that come near to it in terms of specifications. We would even go as far as to say that the N900 has just defined a whole new standard for others to beat. A Linux phone has long been rumoured from Nokia, as many industry observers think that Symbian struggles to meet the needs of newer and more powerful smartphones. Now, if you've ever seen a Nokia 770, N800 or N810 in the real world, you might be shocked at how big they are. They're so big that they're difficult to carry around in a pocket. The N900 is a significantly smaller device, weighing 181 grams and measuring 111 by 60 by 18 millimeters, compared with 226 grams and 128 by 72 by 14 millimeters with the N810. This smaller size is mostly achieved through having a smaller display, a 3.5-inch 800 by 480 pixel touchscreen panel, as opposed to the 4.1-inch display on the N810. The N900 is smaller and lighter than the Nokia E92, although Nokia don't seem to be pitching the N900 as a replacement for the E90. There's a small slide-out QWERTY keypad with just three rows of keys and no navigation pad. If you're used to the more traditional layout of the E90, then you might find it a little disappointing, but it does look better than the keypad on the Nokia N97. What really sets the Nokia N900 apart from the competition is the new MAMO 5 operating system, which is arguably the most powerful platform available on any mobile phone today. Based on the Debian Linux distribution, the N900 offers the possibility of some very sophisticated applications being available in the future. This runs on a 600 MHz ARM Cortex-A8 processor with 256 MB of onboard RAM plus 768 MB of virtual memory for applications to use. The supplied software includes a Mozilla-based browser with full support for Flash and Web 2.0 technologies, an email client which includes support for Microsoft Exchange, instant messaging, a media player, PDF reader, calendar and a range of other applications. MAMO allows PC-style multitasking, and the new version of the interface is extremely polished-looking and certainly appears to be as good as anything else on the market. There are a wide range of personalization and customization options, and there's also a lively developer community for add-ons. The operating system and applications can be updated over the air, so there's no need to plug in a PC. We mentioned earlier that this is the first internet tablet that's also a phone. The Nokia N900 has 900, 1700 and 2100 MHz UMTS plus quad-band GSM. It also supports HSPA, HSDPA, high-speed data, with maximum download speeds of 10 megabits per second and a maximum upload speed of 2 megabits per second. As with previous internet tablets, the N900 supports 802.11b and g Wi-Fi, and unlike the iPhone, you can use the N900 as a tethered modem on a laptop computer. Internal flash memory is up to 32 GB, which indicates that perhaps there will be a few different models available. The N900 will also take a 16 GB microSD card, although it's possible that it will be able to take higher capacity cards when they become available. On top of that, there's an integrated GPS receiver plus OV maps for personal navigation. The large touchscreen should suit in-car navigation, although the GPS on the old N810 was often not all that reliable. Hopefully this has now been fixed. The N900 also has a decent camera, in this case a 5 megapixel unit with autofocus, dual LED flash and a Carl Zeiss lens. Video recording is up to 800 by 480 pixels at a maximum of 25 frames per second, which is comparable with other high-end Nokia handsets. There's a VGA resolution camera on the front for video calling. You can geotag photos and videos with GPS coordinates, and the N900 also includes a photo editor. Pictures can be uploaded and shared with others via Flickr or Ovi. The media player can cope with MP3, AAC, M4A, WAV and Windows Media Audio, plus MPEG-4, H.264, H.263, XVID and Windows Media Video Clips. You can output video to a TV using the supplied video out cable and listen to audio using the standard 3.5mm audio socket. The N900 also comes with an FM transmitter, so you can play back to almost any stereo system without wires. The N900 is designed to be always online, and this does tend to eat into the battery life. The 1320mAh battery gives up to 5 hours talk time on 3G and 9 hours talk time on GSM. Nokia haven't quoted a standby time, as they envisage that the N900 will always have some sort of active data connection, which it should be able to manage for 2 to 4 days on a full charge. Nokia also say that the battery should be able to drive the N900 for a whole day's active use. Charging is done through the N900's micro USB port, so we guess that it can also be charged from a laptop, as well as the supplied AC10 charger unit. So, it's an utterly comprehensive device when it comes to specifications, and there are perhaps only two things that we can see that might be a problem. The first is the screen size. 3.5 inches is big, but nowhere near as big as the 4.1 inches on the previous model. The second problem is price. Nokia say that the N900 will cost around €500 before tax and subsidy, and you can buy a laptop computer for that price. Nokia say the N900 should be available during the fourth quarter of 2009 in any colour you like, just as long as it's black.